Hey y'all, Eric Sky here, and I've got Sean Coonery, the enormous Maine Coon cat. And first of all, I want to give a big shout out to Knee Bunker. He commented on my channel and said, this video and your last video are the same video, by the way. So this video actually is my Parrot ANAFI in-app purchases video. And what happened, I accidentally posted the same video twice, so I never got that video out there. So I had deleted the original, so I'm having to refilm it, but I'm going to refilm it. So Parrot ANAFI in-app purchases. So I've been, you know, keeping a close eye on all the video comments in regards to Parrot ANAFI and trying to find, you know, before my Parrot ANAFI arrives, trying to find the good and the bad. I mean, again, you know, this channel, I like to keep everything very, very honest and, you know, take it out in the field, see what it does. It's good. That's great. If it's not, it's not. But I don't sugarcoat anything. And one of the things that, one of the recurring themes throughout the comments on my channel and other channels is on my social media, rather, not just YouTube, but Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and Instagram. One of the recurring themes has been, did you know that Parrot ANAFI has in-app purchases? Now, since the Parrot ANAFI is not yet released, it's impossible to determine if that's the truth, but the rumors suggest that there may be certain functionality that the Parrot ANAFI has, and if you're looking at the DJI world, that's probably along the lines of what DJI refers to as intelligent flight modes. But there may be certain functionality within the Parrot ANAFI's app that you have to pay to unlock. And I think that sounds stupid. And if that's the case, that's definitely a negative for Parrot. And I hope it's not the case. I don't use, with my DJI products, I typically rarely use the autonomous flight modes. One that I do use with the Mavic Pro quite a bit is the Asteroid, just because it's such a cool effect. It looks like it's coming in from orbit, and it goes right down to the subject. I think that's a very cool effect, and I use it, but most of the other intelligent flight modes, since I've been flying drones for so long, I can orbit an object. I can do that manually. I can do a drone-y or a selfie shot, whatever you want to call it. I can do that manually. There's a lot of creative shots that I can do manually, so I seldom use the autonomous flight modes and DJI speak intelligent flight modes. But if that's something that Parrot's going to do within their app, and again, this is just a rumor, but I just wanted to share because a lot of people were talking about it. If that's something they're going to do, I think that's, you know, from a business perspective, that's probably really going to hurt their reputation. Especially since it seems that Parrot is wanting to enter the prosumer drone space, you know, and compete with products like Mavic Air, Mavic Pro, and Phantom. So, and I hope that's the case, and I hope that if that's not a rumor and if that does materialize, I hope that they do away with that, because that's probably going to deter a lot of would-be Parrot drone adopters. I mean, not everybody that's getting into this hobby has a lot of flight experience. So, you know, if you assume that out of the box, that, well, if I want to do this, if I want to do that, then I'm going to have to pay this or pay that, that could be a major deterrent. So I hope it doesn't happen. I mean, for me, that's not a deal breaker for me. Neither is the lack of obstacle avoidance. I would like to have had obstacle avoidance on the Parrot ANAFI because it makes the drone be perceived as more safe. And, you know, for the drone industry as a whole, that's a huge thing, because we've got a lot of people committing less than responsible acts with their drones. And it's giving the hobby of flying drones a bad name at an international level. So, you know, anything I can do to make the hobby be perceived as more safe, you know, I'll do it. Everything from prop guards to saying, hey, my drone's got obstacle avoidance. Never trust obstacle avoidance. Always assume that it's going to run into something to be safe. But the fact that it's there could potentially prevent a collision. But I can understand, if Parrot failed to include obstacle avoidance because they wanted to reduce cost and be able to better compete with DJI's prices, You know, if that's the case, then, you know, they may be doing this, if this in-app purchase thing is not just a rumor, they may be doing that to try to recover some money. I don't know. But anyway, tell me what you think. Do you think Parrot ANAFI in-app purchases, do you think that's just a rumor? Or do you think it's going to materialize when the Parrot ANAFI hits? It's, let's see, what is today? Like the middle of June? When it hits, hopefully in early July. I don't know. Tell me what you think. Be sure to subscribe, youtube.com/iRicksGuy. And again, check the link within this video's description because you can find the Parrot ANAFI, and I'll be adding a bunch of stuff there, accessories and a whole lot more. Thanks for your viewership, and y'all have a good day. And be sure to subscribe, youtube.com/iRicksGuy. Hey y'all, iRicksGuy here. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to subscribe, like, and share. It's viewers like you that enable my channel to continue to grow. Thank you.